है. सो नाउ देयर इज अ वीडियो. हाँ जी, आर यू एबल टू सी दिस वीडियो? नाउ द सिस्टम इज फाइन, राइट? ओके. सो बेटा, दिस इज यस. सो दिस इज अ वीडियो दैट विच इज गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द कंसेप्ट ऑफ द इनेट इम्यूनिटी एंड द एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनिटी, दैट विच वी हैव स्टडीड जस्ट नाउ, राइट? सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, सो हैव अ लुक ऑन दिस.
Qualities from people around us who compare us with our parents. We usually find people saying things like, she's got her excellent drawing skills from her dad, or her beautiful singing is inherited from her mom. These are the qualities we inherit from our parents and which are present since birth. But there are several qualities which an individual develops in their lifetime, depending on their interests and needs, like developing certain abilities, learning new languages, and so on. This happens gradually over a period of time as and when new interests or needs are encountered. This analogy can be used to study the types of immunity in humans. We have got introduced to the two major types of immunity in the previous video. These are the innate and the acquired immunity. Let's get into the details of these types now. We will begin our journey by learning about the innate immunity first. The term innate means inborn or congenital. That is, innate here stands for being present since birth. So is this type of immunity present in the organism since birth? That's right. All humans are born with an innate ability to fight off infections. This type of immunity is called innate immunity. And since it's present by birth, the type is not specific to any particular infection. Rather, it's a non-specific type. That means the ability helps the body fight various acute infections on its own. Now, to fight the invading antigens, the system has to be prepared with some strong armed forces, right? In this case, the innate immunity has a few components that help it perform the necessary task. These include the physical barriers of the body, physiological barriers, the cells of the immune system, and a few other important molecules. Let's have a look at these individually. The first one on this are the physical barriers. We say that innate immunity is the one in which we evolve. So the physical barriers we can do with the organs or the secretions which help us fight infections. Can you cite an example for me? The largest human organ, that is the skin, as the first line of defense for the human body. So this is an excellent example of the innate immunity. Similar to the skin, there are several other physical barriers like the mucous cortex and the respiratory, the urogenital, and the gastrointestinal tract. On similar lines, we have physiological barriers and cellular ones as well. The physiological barriers include the obstacles for the foreign invaders like acids present in the stomach, saliva secreted by the salivary glands, and more. And do we know cellular barriers are? The immune cells like the lymphocytes and the monocytes form the cellular barriers as the invaders have to face them as soon as they enter the body. Now, which are the other molecules that we have mentioned? We know that the immune cells are capable of producing target-specific proteins called the antibodies against the invaders. The various types of antibodies that are grouped as the molecules produced for fighting off infections. Now, since all the components, that is, the physical barriers, the physiological ones, and the immune cells are present in our body right since birth, they are categorized as the components of innate immunity. Now that we've learned about the innate immunity, which is the first type of immunity, let's move ahead with the second type. The next type is acquired immunity. Here, as the name suggests, the immunity is acquired by the individual in due course of time. It's a type of immunity which is developed over a period of time and is highly specific in nature. And how does immunity develop gradually over time? We understand the fact that we're born with some ability to fight infections naturally, as it happens in the case of innate immunity. community of some specific type be developed? Let's understand that with an example. People these days love to ride their bikes without wearing a helmet. That is definitely not a safe option. If a person comes across any unfortunate accident, then the lesson for lifetime is learned from it. Over a period of time, the person develops a fear for the unfortunate happening and learns how to take precautions to avoid it. Same is the case with our acquired community. These are the numerous microbes present around us. They constantly find an opportunity to enter our body. Thus, our body has to encounter numerous pathogenic microbes constantly. These encounters help our body to develop strategies to fight these invaders. And this is how immunity is developed against specific pathogens that attack us. And this type of immunity keeps developing over our lifetime as we keep encountering several invaders. This is nothing but acquired immunity. One of the simplest examples of acquired immunity is that of chickenpox infection. The chickenpox virus will act as the antigen and our body will synthesize antibodies against it as an immune response. Our immune system has a very effective memory, also known as immunological memory. So once the antibodies against this particular virus are synthesized, then the next time the body will recognize the same antigen and destroy it before it can cause any sort of infection. This is how the acquired immunity works. Now that we've got introduced to it, let's get into the details and the types of acquired immunity in the next video.
Ji beta, so is this clear? Any doubt to anyone? After listening to this particular video, I hope you people have got this concept again, betterly fit into your mind. That is the two types of immunities, that is innate by birth and acquired, which is taken during the lifespan. As there was also an example given in that the person learns from the mistakes. So are our cells that which also learns from the mistake, that is a mistake done during the chickenpox. The chickenpox virus that entered into our body, first response, symptoms were created, disease was there. And secondly, that was the body was capable of fighting against it. Okay? So this is how the two types of immunities that work together in our body, that is preventing ourselves from the various pathogens, preventing our body from getting the various types of the diseases. But if the person is suffering from any particular disease, means that all these particular components, they have failed to fight against it. For example, there are certain of the microbes that which are very strong. You'll be studying about the HIV here. That is a human immunovirus that causes the disease AIDS. Okay. So HIV is a very strong virus, right? Uske bare mein hum baad mein baat karenge. But there are certain small little topics which are present over here. That is after your two types of immunities. Now we are going to the next categorization. That is the active immunity and the passive immunity. Active and passive. The two types of immunities based upon whether they are produced by our body, the immunity it is produced by our body, or we are introducing the immunity within our body. That is, we are artificially adding the immunity to our body, right? So that is called as a passive immunity. When we are adding this antibodies, which are already made, that is the ready-made antibodies ko jab inject kiya jata hai, yani jaise vaccinations hain, hai na? So the ready-made antibodies ko, क्योंकि हमारी बॉडी बना नहीं पा रही है, खुद से नहीं इंट्रोड्यूस कर पा रही है, खुद से नहीं जनरेट कर पाती है, सिंथेसाइज नहीं कर पाती है, सो दोस काइंड ऑफ द एंटीबॉडीज वी हैव टू गेट इट आर्टिफिशियली, दैट इज थ्रू द वैक्सीनेशंस. ठीक है, फॉर एग्जांपल जैसे अभी चिकन पॉक्स में हुआ, तो चिकन पॉक्स में हमारी बॉडी ने खुद से मेमोराइज किया एंड देन आफ्टर दैट इट स्टार्टेड प्रोड्यूसिंग द एंटीबॉडीज फॉर द लेटर फंक्शन, है ना. बाद में जो एंटीजेंस के अगेंस्ट जब उसको इन्फेक्शन के अगेंस्ट अपना एक्शन देना था, तो उसने अंदर अपने खुद से जनरेट किया, हमारी बॉडी ने एंटीबॉडीज को जनरेट किया. सो व्हाट इज दैट काइंड ऑफ इम्यूनिटी? दैट इज क्रिएटेड एज अ एक्टिव इम्यूनिटी. ओके, व्हेन आवर बॉडी इज सेल्फ सिंथेसाइजिंग दीज थिंग्स, राइट. बट इफ इन केस लाइक चिकन पॉक्स, जैसे आजकल के टाइम में क्या है, पहले तो जब भी इन्फेंट्स होते थे, अभी कुछ साल पहले की अगर हम बात करें, तो इन्फेंट्स में इंजेक्शन बूस्टर्स दिए जाते थे, not for the chicken pox, but for the other diseases like that of MMR, whooping mumps, measles, or rubella, you know, yeah, for DPT ke boosters, diye jaate hain, polio injections, or sorry, polio ki vaccination drops, jo hain, wo di jaati hain, theek hai? So these are all the things that which are initially added to the infant's body. Matlab wo pre-form karke, yani ki alag se bana ke, ready-made jo antibodies bane hain, unko dal diya jata hai within the body. ठीक है, रेडीमेड अगर हम लोग इम्यूनिटी जो है वो ले रहे हैं आर्टिफिशियल सोर्सेज से अपनी बॉडी के अंदर इंट्रोड्यूस करवा रहे हैं, देन दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग इज कॉल्ड एज अ पैसिव इम्यूनिटी. ओके, इट इज नॉट ऑलवेज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द वैक्सीनेशंस और द मेडिसिंस ओनली, दिस इज ऑल्सो कैन बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द लाइक मदर्स मिल्क, जो मदर मिल्क होता है इनिशियल मदर मिल्क, दैट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द कोलेस्ट्रम विच इज अ येलोइश फ्लूइड. Right, this initial mother milk, you must have heard in the advertisements also that colostrum is also very important as the initial, during the initial period of the lactation, there is a yellowish secretion and that should be given to the infants because this is the rich source of the immunoglobulins into the infant's body. Okay, so infant initially jaise colostrum mother milk leta hai to usme se isko IgA type ke antibodies jo hain wo introduce hote hain iski body mein, infant's ki body mein. Right, even the placenta that also provides a certain type of the immunoglobulins or antibodies to the infant. So where these categories will be placed, that is getting the already formed antibodies from colostrum, hai na, colostrum se already jo ready made antibodies ban chuke the jo mother ke andar bane hue hai na, to wahi supply kiye ja rahe hain to the infant. So for the infant, what is this immunity type? It's a passive immunity. Right, similarly if the placenta during the time of the pregnancy, that is the child has not been born yet, so during that particular time also the placenta is providing certain immunoglobulins to the infants, so that also are the ready made antibodies which are given to the infant, so they are also coming under the category of the passive immunity. Okay, so is the generation of the capacity or the capability of the body to fight against the diseases, that is called as a immunization. Immunization क्या है? It is again a that is a program, we can say immunization programs, जैसे pulse polio program है वो introduce किया गया है, that is to basically eradicate the most dangerous types of the diseases, you know, as possible as we can. So that is done by giving the artificial sources to the human bodies so that their body can be capable of fighting against the particular diseases. So that is immunization. Again, the immunization can be a passive immunization, that is through vaccinations. ठीक है, इसको हम passive immunization भी कह सकते हैं क्योंकि हम vaccination से या medicine से, जैसे pulse drops हैं, pulse polio drops हैं, तो उनको introduce किया जा रहा है into the body. So we are giving the living organism, the human beings, the types of the antibodies which are already preformed. ठीक है, if an example we take, like अगर किसी को कोई snake bite हो जाता है या फिर कोई भी problem like typhoid वगैरह जैसी कोई problems हो जाती है, तो at that particular time also how to fight against the particular thing. Snake bite के लिए पहले से pre boosters तो दिए नहीं जाते, but yes, लेकिन जब भी उसको treat किया जाता है तब भी हमें preformed antibodies ही introduce करनी पड़ती है, है ना? We are not to wait for the person to produce the antibodies against that particular dangerous venom, that of the snakes, है ना? जो उनका जहर है उसके लिए हम लोग ये नहीं वेट करेंगे कि the person has to create the antibodies. Active is going to be produced. No, this is a preformed antibodies which are entered into the body, which are introduced into the body of the patient, and hence that leads to the passive immunization. Okay, that is through the vaccinations. What immunization we get? That is the passive immunization. Okay, so this was a small little introduction about the active and the passive, other types of the immunities. Right? Clear? Now, if our immune responses are generated to a very harsh manner, means what that is? You can say. Some of the symptoms which are produced, not the symptoms kind, but we can say some of the reactions which are given against a certain of the antigens by our body, they can be the ones which are very harsh to our body, that is the ones which are not going to produce any disease symptoms, but yes, they are producing certain responses. Those responses, that is the ones which are not included as the symptoms of the diseases, matlab jinko hum symptoms of the disease nahi keh sakte, but they are, yes, of course, worst for our body, they are not liked by our body, those symptoms they can also lead to the those responses, not the symptoms. Those responses can also lead to the occurrence of the allergies. ठीक है, उनको हम बोलते हैं allergy. यानी जैसे अगर supposing if a person is having the allergy from the pollen grains से, ठीक है, एयर में पॉलन ग्रेन्स हैं तो हार्वेस्टिंग के टाइम पे पॉलन ग्रेन्स से एलर्जी होता है अगर किसी को. द बॉडी ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट इज हार्वेस्टिंग कहीं और चल रही है, पॉलन ग्रेन्स आर देयर इन द एयर एंड द बॉडी इज गोइंग टू रिस्पॉन्ड इक्विवेलेंटली. ठीक है, क्यों? क्योंकि उसकी बॉडी उन सराउंडिंग फीचर्स को, उन सराउंडिंग एलिमेंट्स को रिसीव नहीं कर पा रही है इन अ बेटर मैनर. ठीक है, एंड इट इज ऑल्सो ट्रीटिंग दोज pollen grains, they are not the pathogens, है ना. So those agents or the those things that which are present in the surrounding environment, उनको भी ये as a pathogen लेके चलती है हमारी body and it is producing the responses to it. And what responses are then produced? They are called as the allergies. ठीक है, allergy कैसे कैसे materials के साथ हो सकती है, what all materials are involved which can be treated as allergens, जिनको हम allergens कह सकते हैं. For example, there can be the dust. Simple dust can be there within the surrounding air, right? Or there can be certain microbes or the small organisms which are present within the dust, like that of the mites which are present within the dust. Pollens can be there, you know, pollen grains can be there, even the fibers, when the harvesting of the fibrous materials that is taking place, then that can also be acting as a allergen, you know. एनिमल्स की जो कैसे स्केली वो होती है प्रोडक्शंस, है ना, मतलब उनकी स्किन की कोई कोट्स वगैरह अगर रिमूवल हो रही है, स्केली प्रोडक्शंस, जैसे स्किन हमारा भी रिमूव होता है, हमारा ड्राई हो जाता है एंड स्केल्स दे आर रिमूवल आउट, तो उनके लिए भी कुछ लोगों को इतना ज्यादा एलर्जी रहता है दैट देयर बॉडी स्टार्ट रिएक्टिंग टुवर्ड्स दोस थिंग्स. ठीक है, इवन वी कुड नॉट नोटिस इवन इन द नॉर्मल कंडीशंस, बट अ फ्यू ऑफ द पीपल दोज हु आर हैविंग द you can say disturbed immunity because of these particular animal dander bolte hai isko, jo skin ke dry skin ke jo kuch scaly productions hoti hain ya feathers mein se hairs jo remove out hote hain ya unki jo productions hoti hain that which are left out, the waste or the dead tissues we can say, hai na. So the dead tissues of the animals, that is through the skin or through the feathers, their coatings, they are all included under the animal dander. ओके, तो इन सब के लिए भी कुछ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म जैसे ह्यूमंस के लिए कुछ लोगों में इन्फेक्शंस होती हैं, एलर्जीज होती हैं. ठीक है, सो दिस इज बेसिकली द सम ऑफ द एलर्जेंस. अदरवाइज इफ यू गो इन डेप्थ तो आप लोगों को पता चलेगा, कई लोगों को तो लैक्टोज से एलर्जी होता है, कईयों को प्रोटीनिशियस फूड से एलर्जी होता है. ठीक है, वीट में जैसे वो माल्ट होती है, शायद माल्ट से कईयों को एलर्जी होती है. मींस दे इवन लुक फॉर द फूड आइटम्स व्हिच इज नॉट हैविंग द वीट, व्हिच इज नॉट हैविंग द माल्ट इन इट, व्हिच इज नॉट हैविंग द लैक्टोज शुगर इन इट. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ द डेंजरस एलर्जीज कैन ऑल्सो बी देयर. ओके, एंड वॉट एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दीज एलर्जीज, बेसिकली ये रिजल्ट, मतलब ऐसा होता क्यों है, एलर्जीज ऐसे क्यों बन जाती है, हमारी बॉडी कैसे रिस्पॉन्ड करती है जब ये एलर्जीज बनती है. देर आर सर्टन सेल्स लाइक दैट ऑफ द मास्ट सेल्स which produce certain secretions that is in the form of the histamine or the serotonins, hai na. So they are producing certain chemicals in the form of histamine or serotonin. These are the certain chemicals that which can be produced from the mast cells in concern to the allergens when they attack the body, and hence they produce this particular allergies. ओके, दैट इज वाई अवर बॉडी स्टार्ट्स रिस्पॉन्डिंग, क्योंकि ये जो केमिकल्स हैं हमारी बॉडी के लिए अच्छे नहीं है, एंड हेंस दे प्रोड्यूस द रिवर्स रिस्पॉन्सेज और द वर्स्ट रिस्पॉन्सेज दैट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द एलर्जीज. ओके, व्हाट एंटी एलर्जिक ड्रग्स कैन बी यूज्ड, एंटी हिस्टामिन्स कैन बी यूज्ड. ठीक है, स्टीरॉइड्स आर देयर व्हिच आर गिवन टू द पेशेंट्स व्हिच आर सफरिंग विद द एलर्जीज, राइट. दीज ड्रग्स दैट व्हिच आई एम राइटिंग राइट नाउ, दैट इज एंटीहिस्टामिन्स हो गए या फिर स्टीरोइड्स हो गए, एड्रिनालिन हो गया, ये सारे जो ड्रग्स अभी दिए जाते हैं अगेंस्ट द एलर्जीज, देयर बाय दे आर इंट्रोड्यूसिंग वन ऑफ द इम्यूनोग्लोबुलिन्स दैट इज IgE स्पेसिफिकली फॉर द एलर्जीज, राइट. विच टाइप ऑफ द एंटीबॉडीज आर प्रोड्यूस्ड हेयर दैट इज फॉर द एलर्जीज, दैट आर द IgE टाइप. हमने ये पांच चार लिखी थी अभी इससे पहले, उनमें से A is given through the colostrum, and E is given, or you can say introduced into the body against the allergies. Okay, against allergies by any of the drugs, but against the allergies, right? So this is about the allergy. Now there is also one more feature about the living organisms or the higher organisms. What happens actually? Normally क्या होता है कि pathogen क्या है? That is again a living cell, we can say, है ना, living organism है. That is in our surrounding and it is going to enter into our body. Viruses, they are non-living outside and living inside. ठीक है, that's an exception. But otherwise, normally saying, they are also the cellular materials, the living organisms that which attack the body and that which causes the diseases, है ना? तो वो भी एक लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स ही हैं हमारी बॉडी के अंदर जो कि अटैक करेंगे, है कि नहीं? लेकिन अब हमारी बॉडी को कैसे पता चलेगा कि ये वाला एक ऐसा सेल है जो कि एक पैथोजन है ना, या ये सेल जो है वो मेरा अपना सेल है? मींस हाउ द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर कैपेबल ऑफ डिफरेंशिएटिंग, दिस इज बेसिकली द मेमोरी बेस्ड इम्यूनाइजेशन विच इज अ फीचर ऑफ द हायर ऑर्गेनिजम्स. ठीक है, हायर ऑर्गेनिजम्स जो होते हैं वो मेमरी बेस्ड टेक्नोलॉजीज लगाते हैं, दैट इज फॉर डिफरेंशिएटिंग बिटवीन द एक्सटर्नल टाइप ऑफ द सेल विच इज द आउटसाइड सोर्स, ठीक है, नॉट फ्रॉम द बॉडी, एंड द सेकेंडली द सेल्फ सेल्स, मतलब अपने ही सेल्स, ताकि वो अपने सेल्स को डैमेज ना करें और सिर्फ दूसरे जो पैथोजन्स आ रहे हैं उनके अगेंस्ट ये फाइटिंग्स करें, है ना? But in the few conditions, there are certain cells, there are certain immunization programs, the certain immunizations which are created within our body, that which could not differentiate between the self cells and the external cells or the pathogens. ठीक है, जब ऐसा differentiation नहीं हो पाता, एक feature तो ये है कि higher organisms memory base इसमें differentiating कर लेते हैं, लेकिन दूसरा feature ये भी है कि कुछ एक cells में differentiation नहीं करी जाती, जिस वजह से क्या होता है, इम्यूनिटी तो हमने अभी तक पढ़ा, दैट इज टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द पैथोजेंस, है ना? पैथोजेंस आर व्हाट? दे आर द फॉरेन पार्टिकल्स व्हिच आर हार्मफुल टू अस, राइट? सो अगर वो हमारे ही सेल्स को, अपने ही बॉडी के सेल्स को अगर डैमेज करने लग जाए, हमारा इम्यूनिटी हमारे ही सेल्स को, यानी इम्यूनिटी इज गोइंग टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द सेल्फ सेल्स, अपने ही सेल्स के अगेंस्ट फाइटिंग करनी शुरू कर दे, तो हम इसको बोलते हैं ऑटो इम्यूनिटी. This is called as autoimmune response. अपने ही cells के लिए वो immunity create करी जा रहा है. ऐसे में क्या होगा? ऐसे में अपने भी तो damage होंगे ना cells. अपने self cells भी हमारे damage होते हैं. Under this there is a category of a disease which is rheumatoid arthritis. This is a disease which is an autoimmune disease. It is related to the arthritis, means the bone deformities, ठीक है, bones and the joints deformities. Initial stages पे swelling होता है, जैसे एक हमारा normal structure है हमारी fingers का, है ना? So because if the autoimmune responses are generated within our body by age or something other factors, then what is going to happen is the cells of our own body, they are being can say reacted because of the immunity cells. इम्यूनिटी जो हमारी होती है वो अपने आप में ही अपने ही सेल्स के लिए अगेंस्ट दैट वर्क करना शुरू कर देती है. ऐसे में जो हमारी बोन्स हैं या जो जॉइंट्स हैं, फिंगर जॉइंट्स हो गए, जो बोन्स हैं, ये क्या करती हैं? ये डिफॉर्मिटीज, पहले तो इनिशियल स्टेजेस पे स्वेलिंग्स आती हैं, देन इसके बाद इनकी डिफॉर्मिटीज हो जाती हैं, ठीक है. बोन्स जॉइंट्स जो हैं वो खराब हो सकते हैं बहुत ही ज्यादा, मतलब एंगल्स, एक सिंपल सिंगल हैंड के इस तरह से आपको फिंगर्स के एंगल्स अगर नजर आ रहे, they will be properly bent, they will be non-functional, they are not proper having that particular strength in the bones, okay? So all those problems related to the bones and the joints, that is called as a rheumatoid arthritis, and this is a autoimmune disease, which is created by the immunity, which is working against our own cells, okay? So this is a very important example, that is called as a rheumatoid arthritis. Okay, any other question, any further question? After this we have the immune system in our body, and related with that we will be also describing the two of the diseases, that is AIDS and cancer. If anybody is having any doubt in today's lecture, yes.